kasi kinat siya, etc., etc. Nag-create ka na ng interpretation. Oh, question. Question ulit. Ay, aware ka ba doon sa judgment mo? Or automatically, it just went into your head? Pumasok lang ka agad? No? Kasi paminsan, pwede mo naman tingnan siya as just this eh. Kuha mo? Pwede mo naman siya tingnan just as this. Pwede mo naman siya tingnan as just the phone. Grabe no, may ano. Oh, tingnan nyo. Phone.
May palight.
Yeah, oo. So, pwede mo siya matingnan based on the facts man. Pero pwede mo siyang tingnan na bigyan mo siya ng kulay. Important to be fully aware.
Okay. Ayun, yeah. Thanks.
Importante po yun kasi minsan in our many relationships, observe mo sa sarili mo ha, how many times na ikaw mismo nagbigay ka ng interpretations mo na wala naman dun. Parang nag-create ka ng haba ba ko? Parang ano ka, parang sometimes ano ka pa nga eh. Notice mo sa sarili mo, sinusure ka, no? Confident talaga ako. Oo. Pero parang saglit, interpretation ko lang yun eh. Parang, alam mo yun, ang dami nangyayari yan sa community, o, diba? O, for example,
pwede daming natin, assumptions.
Ang dami natin assumptions. So, and because ang dami natin assumptions, at hindi tayo nag-check ng assumptions, we're, parang, kumbaga, everybody is, parang yun na yung version of our truth. Yan.
Kaya,
pero, version of our truth are also our own interpretations.
Yeah. Kung ano yung tingin sa sarili. Ganda ko kahit okay lang.
Kasi, yun. So, now, good guys. Kasi, so for example, ha, paminsan kasi it's nice to really reflect it based on our experiences, eh. Diba? Ito, I'll give you experience. I have to come here to the Philippines because I have a mission, right? I have to come back. I'm here in the Philippines, by the way. So, ngayon, I'll just share to you my experience. So, I flew from Los Angeles to Manila. And prior to that, isa lang po yung luggage ko. Nag-worry ako. As in, worry ako ng worry. Kasi, at the back of my mind, there's one piece of luggage I'm allowed is only 23 kilos. So, clear yon. It is a fact. Kasi, alam naman natin yung law, I mean, yung policy, that you're only allowed 23 kilos. Extra luggage, you have to pay. And within 23 kilos lang. Diba? So, anyway, so, I know, I'm aware as well, that to have an extra luggage is to pay. Correct? So, ngayon, sabi ko dun sa kasama ko kay tita, sabi ko tita during the, before my flight no mga 6 hours before my flight sabi ko worried talaga ako sa luggage ko. This is over for sure, this is over kasi ilang beses na tinatry, over talaga niya, wala yan, okay lang yan kasi babayad ka naman, yun yung interpretation niya. Okay, pero sa mind ko because I'm following the law and policy, I want to be within the 23 kilos. Safe yun eh. Para ako, hindi na ako mag-worry about it. So, but I know that it's over. So, pagdating sa airport, with this, pagdating sa airport, paglagay ko ng luggage ko, nga, over nga, 25 kilos. Oh my gosh! So, emotions are high, heightened ng emotions. So yung confirmed yung ano yung stress etc. Pero there was an invitation prior to that na hindi ka mag-worry because the invitation of God is trust in the Lord, you claim it, God will find a way. So sometimes hindi ka na mag-worry doon, it's just go and just do what you need to do. Parang ganun. Ganun yung invitation ni Lord. So para sabi ko, Pero with my reasonable mind, parang sabi ko, hindi ata ano yun eh, nang di talaga practical yun, you know, I'm really struggling. Pero I'm aware of all the emotions that are happening within me. Pero it's so funny that like, that during that day, I could just be carried away about that reality. Concerned about the luggage. So pagdating ko doon, happy ko na nga ba? You know, at the back of my mind, this is like, what is it? So pag-approach ko sa vice, so I have to pay, sabi ko, I have to pay. Suddenly, the girl, the officer, the counter said, it's okay even if you're over 23 kilos. It's all fine. So, in that context, parang, ay, okay pala to. So in other words, tama yung interpretation ni Tita sa akin na indeed it was fine. Ito pa yung all the more the blessing that came out of it, no? Sabi, yung tinan ko ng one piece of my hand carry, which is also over, because I mean the mindset that is supposed to be 7 kilos when you're traveling international flight, was like, mine was like 11, 12 kilos, over that 5 kilos.
Over the 5 kilos.
Okay, puro siya over lahat. Sabi ng ano, it's fine, you can have it, I'll give it to you for free. So, in a way, it turned out to be a blessing on my part. But also, though, I'm aware that I'm not within the kind of like rule. But that turned out to be my, in other words, that turned out that in terms of my interpretations, sometimes your interpretation could need to be verified from the reality. Mm. And that different factors. Yun yung ibig ko sabihin. And so sometimes, oftentimes, sabi ko nga, tama talaga si Tita. Tita, I believe na ako talaga. Truly, sabi ko sa kanya, you truly an angel. You know, you reminded me of how the Lord will truly work. Amen. And truly, it's happening in our everyday life.
Amen.
So, ang daming mga nangyayari sa atin.
Paalala kay Father.
Ilagay ko to sa application. Ang daming nangyayari sa atin that the Lord is inviting us and developing our level of awareness and make us grow and become better people. In fact, if I may just quote to you our gospel reading for this coming Sunday, our Sunday readings from Timothy, no, chapter 2 to 8 to 13. The saying is trustworthy. Okay? Ito po yung message sa atin as our verse or word of life from 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 8 to 13. If we died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains unfaithful, for he cannot deny himself. So in other words, part of our trustworthiness is to cling to Christ. Part of our trustworthiness is to be faithful in little things. Now, question. Now we have learned and identified that it's important to be aware about developing, understanding our programming, our influence. We have learned as well to identify and name, no? Notice sa mga sinasabi ko, in a way, we've learned and identify and name the fact that we have to distinguish facts and interpretation. Also, having a level of awareness that you have assumption. Importante po yun, ha? Making a distinction between facts and interpretation. Kasi, importante din in many dramas, na minsan kasi ang daming drama sa buhay. Okay? Kapag maraming drama sa buhay, titanong yung sarili mo, interpretation ko lang ba yun or ano ba talagang reality or facts? Observe yourself kapag may chismis, o marites dyan, o nagmamarites. O, identify yourself kapag nagmamarites ka lang kasi nagmay-making ka interpretation, or are you making a conversation to others in terms of, ito ha, importante distinction, ito po yung narinig ko po. Importante yun to make a statement like that. Kasi sabihin mo, for example, si Maria, I heard from Maria, or at least without identifying, I heard it from someone who shared it to me. I don't know. Okay. So at least sinabi mo yun, ha, na I heard from someone. That means hearsay yun, the first place, I heard from someone. Okay? How many times, ikaw na lang, maging honest ka sa sarili mo, nagsasabi ka ba na I heard from someone? Or parang, nagsalita ka lang with full certainty, no? Parang certain ka na alam mo na rin ano ko nga eh, ito nga eh. Oo. Bigyan mo ito kapag ito po, yun po yung mga situations in life na ang dami natin mga experiences na paminsan hindi tayo nagdi-distinguish. Kaya it could be a result of conflict, and it could be a result of many misinterpretation and misunderstanding within the family, within the community, because we cannot even distinguish the facts and interpretation and our own judgment with it. Kaya nga, kapag ganun nangyayari, yun na yung version of truth mo eh. Alam mo yun? Kasi kapag yung version of truth mo, you hold on with it. Ano to eh? Ito, paglalaban mo, baso to. Oh, ilan ba yung ano dito, yung lemon?
Kalahati lang, Father.
So, oh. Nakikita nyo ngayon.
Father, may question po ako sa ganyan. Paano po kapag halimbawa, yun nga, you have that kind of assumption. So, kumbaga nag-uusap kayo ng, may kausap kang tao. Di ba, member of your family. Ngayon may assumption ka na ganito dun sa sinabi niya. Pero kinommunicate mo sa kanya for you to understand yung part niya kung tama ba yan o hindi. Pero ayaw niyang pag-usapan. Parang gano'n, no? How you as a person, you're aware na this is my assumption dun sa sinabi mo. And you communicate to her that assumption. Pero sa kanya, ayaw niyang i-ano na, okay, tama na lang.
Well, therefore, you'll not attain the full truth. It's just in the, therefore, parang what, therefore, ikaw mismo makatag ng conclusions, you are from the first place, you are from the, you're coming from clarification of the assumption. The person is the holder of the conversation. Siya yung may susi sa pinapag-usapan. Siya yung, kumbaga, siya yung nakakaalam. At the mere fact na hindi niya sinasabi at hindi niya kina-clarify, may tinatago siya, bottom line. Di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Or for whatever reasons, it is respectfully tinatago mo isang bagay because you want to protect it, you want to respectfully hide something, there are many other factors. So, and you could be in a situation na ang dami mo namang assumptions in this context at saka hindi yung tinatago. Therefore, you're in the limbo. You are floating, no? Ayan, nasa hangin po kayo. So in that context, clarity can only happen when your assumptions are being verified and also for you as a person who verified your assumptions are also clear. Kaya nga, importante in terms of self-awareness is to identify na this is your own interpretation lang po. Like, I'm giving talk to you right now. Literally. In this kind of like conversational style way of doing it. So, ang iba sa inyo, like when people are wasting Facebook, if they just pass by, they might just say, ah, wala naman ako may naintindihan dyan. Or for some people, oy, ako parang interesting yan ah. Parang connected yan sa akin ah. You know? Or now, as I'm speaking, how many of you really are just going, you know, are really connecting to what I'm saying? Are you really applying this now to your own personal context, no? Kasi importante yun eh. This will only make sense kapag ina-apply mo sa context and you find that connection eh. Ito itong mga pinagsasalita natin for the last 30 minutes, no? Or, you know, it's really about application to what is going on with your present context. Pero kung hindi mo siya nakukuha, ay sorry po, that means you are not fully aware. That means natutulog ka, o ako gising na. So, tulog ka talaga. Kasi, kahit ano pa mangyari, hindi, kahit pare ka, wala dito pa, pare, mamadre, santo papa ka, whatever. Are you telling me that the Pope, or at least, for example, the bishop, or the learned, everything, they're fully aware, no? Can't be. Kaya nga, awareness is a journey. So, discovering ourselves. And also, the more that you're able to discover yourself, the more that you're able to distinguish yourself, you're better. And then, ang ganda yung sinabi kanina ni Shakina, yung idea of that binasa niya na, you're on the top of that mountain that you're going inward as well. Pero ang daming factors yun, ah. Kasi different landscape yun. Yun. And so, what makes this hilo self effective and helpful in your own personal life if you're able to apply it and you'll find that connection. Ano ba yung nangyayari sa buhay ko that nakikita ko, ay, alam mo, thank you, no, alam ko pala, marami pala akong kailangan matutunan. Marami. Marami tayo lahat na matutunan about ourselves. And even with our families. Oo. Maraming mga factors yun. Okay? Now, do you have any other question? Clarification? Hello? Okay lang? Continue
okay
tayo.
Okay lang po, Father. Yes po.
Now, we have learned about balik po, learning about our programming, no? Ang isang important factor about learning about ourselves, no, discovering about ourselves is and also other than identifying our facts and interpretations, clarifying our assumptions, is also discovering and learning about our impact to our community and to others. So, how do you know your impact on others? Kasi self-awareness is not about solely about yourself only. Hindi mo lang naman sa sarili mo eh. It's really about your relationship with the others eh. So, how do we know about our impact to others? Ano po yung mga factors that we can learn and identify na parang may level of awareness ka in terms of your impact? And how do you attain that? Maraming bagay. Well, first of course, always about self-reflection. But the way you can identify this, ideally speaking, kapag in a very healthy way, if within our community or among members, sana may group, may ano tayo, mayroong parang small group sharing, or apa tayo, there are three people can really be honest, really express how they feel when you're there and when you speak and when you're, you know, it will be important to know the impact. Mm-hmm. Kasi we can only learn it through experiences as well based on our hearing from other people and the feedback that we receive from people around us. And we can only bring this conversation if we are feeling safe with others. Diba? That you're also willing to be comfortable to hear the feedback. Am I making sense?
Yes, po.
Yeah. So, in other words, this is a very important kasi ang impact natin can be both ways yun eh. It's from the self at saka others. So, ang importante, yung others kasi, you need to receive the feedback from others in order to know the impact. Kasi paano mo malaman yun? Hindi mo naman malalaman mo lang yun kapag i-verify mo with others eh, the people concerned you. Pero, meron kang evidence dun or meron kang data dun. And your data is with your parents. For example, with your parents. So, paminsan, ano naririnig mo palagi sa parents mo? Ano ba yung mga right away biases nila that are just coming out? So that gives you the data. Na paminsan if you're, you know, pag malaman mo ang motives mo, palaging interpretation nila sa akin, for example, when you post, for example, in the Facebook, yan, when you post in the Facebook, anything you post on the Facebook is subject for interpretation, no? I post my Facebook Father Joe Blas account. And apparently, the moment I post in the Facebook in a different scenarios, in a different place settings, kala nila kung saan ako nakapunta. That is the assumption.
Di ba yung totoo, Father?
Yes. Ay, nandun si Father sa Italy. Ay, nandun na naman siya sa Assisi. We just celebrated the feast of Our Lady of St. Francis Assisi. Si Father, ganito. The moment you post that is first, in the first place, assumption. So, to interpret, traveling, interpretation po yun, ha? Okay? How do you know? Do you really know that the person there is enjoying? Alam ka yun?
May ambition.
Mas happy or enjoying, ha?
Yeah. Really? Mayaman na daw agad.
So, kung aware ka sa sarili mo, kung anong pinagsasalita mo dyan, Your own interpretation, and it really speaks about you. It's not about the other.
I'm recording that one.
Inaano nyo, naintindihan nyo? Kasi
yes,
kung
okay.
Care, yun na yun, tama na yun. Ang ka na sa version of your own truth.
It's not full yet. Do you want to put?
Ay, paano po yung father?
Yeah.
Ay, 31 ka na. Ay, pa-30 ka. Tapos wala ka pang ka. Assumption nyo lang yun, guys.
Oh,
interpretation nila sa edad mo na dapat may ano ka na, dapat ganyan. Guys, kalma na.
So, is the fact that lahat tayo, every day, we are filled with assumptions, interpretations, we are not verifying the facts, and so we are sometimes, we created a lot of, I call it drama. Paminsan, ang daming drama sa buhay, na paminsan, you know what, you just have to move on, do good, do this, and so pataminsan sa dami mong drama, ang nangyayari, ano ka na ng kaya paminsan, konti lang, nagiging nega ka, nagiging affected ka. That is what happened when the person is not fully aware. Oo. Kasi parang, again, it's because lacking of self-awareness nga, hindi nga nabigyan ng lalim, no? hindi mo talaga na kumbaga parang napasukan, you didn't really enter because or only here. Okay, so ang impact, let me repeat, do you know your impact on others? Two process. Number one is really about yourself and the others, and the others can be attained also from feedback, and the data that you can only get is also the data that is what you hear from others until you really clarify it. Pwede kong sabihin, Angel, Ira, how do you feel about me? No, I mean like in a relationship, ah, kasi this is very important. So that's why as husband and wife or meron kayong relationship, this is a very also this is a secret. In order to develop that relationship between people, ah, kung may husband and wife or people between sisters, you know, kung if you have the guts and the courage to be able to clarify to your sisters, how do you find me? How do you feel about me? How do you clarify? You know, when you clarify that, that is entering into a different level of relationship. Otherwise, it could be it's only in the level of assumptions. Paminsan. And often
family manager daw ako ng pamilya.
Until you really fully open your emotion about yourself, then it's really good. But part of developing your impact to others, understanding your impact to others, is first you have to learn about yourself. Kaya nga importante yung learning about yourself is really your emotions na feeling mo lang to. Kaya nga hindi ka pwedeng magsalita na with certitude. Delikado yun. Kasi kung certitude, eh baka mali po tayo. Diba? Dapat in humility, ito po yung this is what I think, this is what I feel, baka
this is what I've experienced.
Yeah.
My experience lang, pwede clarify mo to sa akin. Ay, oo, ganun. Kasi, ang experience mo is clouded by your own interpretation. Remember? Kaya iba naman pagtingin mo eh. Na ngayon, sa iba, baka iba. O, hindi pala nila, ano. Tapos, for example, balik tayo dun sa dessert. Nakasum tayo na, ay, sarap-sarap ng cake. Yung iba pala, ayaw nyo yung cake, gusto nyo ice cream. Oo. Nag-assume ka na, eh, ang ganda-ganda na ito. Eh, kasi ito yung pupunin ko. Oh, hindi naman pala niya gusto. Diba? Ay, kung may personality naman na so super shy, tataguin niya lang tataguin yun. Masama na palang loob niya. May resentment na pala siya. Oh, ngayon, sino yung talo? Boss. Kawawa ang both people. So now, very important are the boundaries. In order to discover your yourself in terms of your impact is very important is identifying boundaries. Now,
Charmaine.
Okay? Eh, kasi sometimes ang boundaries, ano eh, yung space. Sa Filipino culture, hindi po tayo, I just want to make sure this, I explain this to you kasi this is a very important learning. Okay? Sa Filipino culture po, hindi po tayo natutupo ng boundaries until it's being brought to us. I give you an example. kapag lumaki po tayo sa Pilipinas, eh, di ba, generally, unless super yaman kayo, no, eh, yung bahay natin, I mean, sa Pilipinas, dalawang kwarto lang. Di ba? Eh, kung apat kayo magkakapatid, lima kayo magkakapatid, di ba? Babae, lalaki, dyan, pinagkasya.
Kwarto, yes po.
Minsan, dyan ka na. So, as nung lumalaki ka, like, yun, kung lumalaki ka, sama mo na yung parents mo, parang okay na tayo kasi we are very family-oriented.
Oriented.
It's okay. Okay? Kita mo yung ano yan. Kasi it's part of our orientation. Everything is okay. Kasi nahirap eh. Eh, di pa yung code mo natin. Pagdating mo sa America, North American people, notice nyo, no? Notice nyo, lahat na makakilala nyo, conversation-wise, lahat no, eh, dalawa na yung anak. Isa lang ang
nawala ba si father, guys? Oo. Legit na sa Pilipinas siya. Father, nawala po kayo.
Ang signal ni father.
Ayan. Father. Father. Hello po. Ayan, dalawa lang ang anak. Dito kasi mahirap ang buhay, father. Mahirap bumuhay ng bata, mahal. Sa Pilipinas, okay lang po. Kahit ilan pwede. Bala na sila sa buhay nila. Diba? Pwede daw yun doon ang gatas na app galing sa rice. Ayan. Father, nawala po kayo.
Oo nga eh. Sorry ha. Parang okay. Super excited sinasabi ko.
Kaya hindi ata kinaya ng ano internet nyo yung bigat ng ano ilang anak.
Hindi kinaya o
hindi kinaya yung katotohanan.
Fully aware ako doon sa excitement ko kasi emotionally when there is so much inspiration and you know that you're speaking with the truth,
yes.
You know, and you know that this is happening in,
yes,
reality, and
yes,
I've seen it in North America, in Canada, makikita mo yung distinction yun, iba po,
yes,
yun, and that is part of boundaries that we're speaking,
yes.
So since culturally we're speaking about these boundaries, importante yun na from the parents' perspective maintindihan nyo yun na sa amin, so una ito dito, okay lang yun, ganito. Pero sa kanila, kasi kung na you grew up in United States, sa mga language ng conversation in the peers, iba. So, noon, dati, hindi mo pa natutunan yun. Kasi, wow, they have this, they have toys, etc. Ganyan-ganyan. So, maraming mga factors that are boundaries that are actually cultural. Noon, nakikita mo na na culturally, kaya sa Amerika, importante talaga, or, you know, boundaries, but generally speaking, in all this context and this life, boundaries. May importante yung boundaries. Now, so there are different kinds of boundaries. So material boundaries, it's actually, when you speak about material boundaries, it's a regulation whether, whether you contribute and offer, such as your car, your cell phones, money, etc., to others. That it becomes a public possession, hindi naman pwede yun, di ba? You need to make sure na, no, cellphone ko to, private to. Hindi to pwede buksan ng kapatid mo. O, di ba? You are already invading my space. O, di ba? Parang ganun. Physical boundaries. You know that? Privacy. That's why, when you go to the washroom, you lock the door. That's what, you know, diba? Women would want to make sure that, please, step out. You know, you're entering into my space. Mental boundaries, that's very important, you know. It refers to your beliefs, your thoughts, and ideas. And so, ang question dito, are you aware of what you believe? Yun yung importante. Do you find, ito another question, do you find yourself easily persuaded or strong-minded ka or combination of both? Basta-basta ka ba naniwala? Hearsay pa lang, naniwala ka na kagad? Biniverify mo ba yung narinig mo? Or at least in-identify mo na, ay, narinig ko lang yun. Hindi naman, hindi ko na pagbigyan ng pansin yun. O, di ba? Now, are you able to listen with an open mind? Okay, very important. Are you able to listen with an open mind while being aware of your own thoughts and paradigms? Ayun. So, yan yung sasabi ko, Alan. Again,
Are you able to make a distinction between facts and interpretation without being biased? And able to say to yourself, no, like example ko lang kanina si Angel, sabi niya, ito po yung sa personal ko, ito po yung sa work ko. So, you know, those are distinctions. Those are being identified. You know, ito po yung experience ko. You know, those are, you know, are beneficial and helpful. That means, in-apply. Oh. That means, kaya nga, therefore, kung if you are a person who is fully aware, you need also to realize that we need mentors. Oh. We need to verify. Kasi, but our verification of many other experiences could be based as well with substance. Diba? Kasi you could say, for example, no, in a family context, example, palagi na lang yung, example na lang, palagi yung tatay, nagagalit. Diba pa, palagi siya nagagalit. Isang ganito lang, galit siya. That's already an experience. One experience. Two experiences. Three experiences. Four. Circumstances, ganun na. In other words, ang statement mo na sinasabi is substantial experiences to be able to make a judgment that when it comes to many other circumstances, ito po ay yung nangyayari. Yan. Kaya, it is based on those substantial experiences that we can also speak with truth. Na dito na po yung experience mo. Kaya, confirm yung mga feelings mo. Oo. At magiging confirmed yun because you know already.
Verify.
Na ganyan. Now, I spoke so many things and I'd like to bring your attention sana sa clarifications, questions, kasi mas mabigyan natin ng connection sa totoong buhay kapag may mga questions kayo, at least ano ba yung mga ano nyo, what are your takeaways from the conversation that we have or learnings?
Guys, meron ba? Ako parang may come up into my mind na yun nga yung sinabi nyo about distinctions from ayun, setting boundaries. Kinall out ko yung attention this short talaga. Setting boundaries when it comes to, kasi di ba po, we have different phases ng life natin. You have work, you're a youth leader, you are a daughter, di ba, kapatid ka, ganyan. So, bilang ano po, yung siniset mo yung sarili mo, iba-iba. Kumbaga, kapag kapatid ako, so I remind myself na, oh, hindi kayo leader dyan. So, dapat sa kapatid mo, nakikinig ka lang, ate ka, ganyan. So, hindi kayong ano, angel na nasa gawain, ha? Mayos ka. So, kapag ano naman po sa trabaho, and oh, ngayon naman, professional ka, hindi ka ano, yung pa-jolly-jolly dyan, paano-ano lang. So, dapat nasa serious mode ka, ganyan, sa work. And, ayun nga, kapag dito katulad kanina, meron po kaming galing dito sa bahay nila Marlene. O, mamaya, ayan, masaya-masaya ka ngayon, mamaya, iba naman. So, ano mo yung sarili mo, ayusin mo. Yung kumbaga, father, may ano ka na, may, like, fully aware ka na meron kang gagawin or meron kang, alam mo yun, naiiba yun, nasi-shift.
That was, there is a role that you play. In other words, a role that you play, but you're still the same person. It doesn't mean na i-compartmentalize niyo po, ha? I don't want to sound that I want to be, you're compartmentalizing it because practically speaking, you're just one. Like, you are jublas. You're jublas.